So let's have a test on cauliflower mountain. Yeah, come on. So let's have a short test on the ramp of cauliflower mountain. Hello and welcome to RC Bells, and thanks for stopping by. In many of my last videos, I talked about cauliflower mountain, the suitcase crawler course I made, this little ramp, and some of you mentioned that I should use smaller crawlers than the 1x24 cars. So I wanted to have an HO car, which I couldn't get. It was sold out, so I bought this SNT 1x64 car, which doesn't fit really to the mountain. And with a lack of ground clearance, it always gets stuck or fall over. So many of you, John Foster, Mark from RCU in the chat, and I think Nixter from Nixter RC2 mentioned I should do a 1x32 Orlandoo car. I wasn't quite sure because the Orlandoo cars, or Orlandoo, are kits and not easy to build. Many, many very tiny screws, and even the 1x24 cars are big compared to the Orlandoos. But then Furitek released an Orlandoo car. This is the OH32X01 crawler, and it has Furitek technology in it. The Ant motor, the ESC, and in this video I show you what's in the box, what I get, and why this car is so great. So there isn't a big unboxing because I already had opened it. I come at the end of this video for the reason why I did this. The box is just cardboard, nothing spectacular. When you open it, you get a little manual about the car and the technology and the app. Then there's just a little bit of foam, the charger, the transmitter. Quite simple, you have to add 4 AAA batteries. A little bit of more foam at the bottom of the box, and this is everything. And here is the car. There's even the Orlandoo sign on it. The battery is already stuffed in here. It's a 210 milliampere hour battery, a 2S cell. We have a brushless motor. The Ant with 3456 kV. It's a 12-pole motor, and it's original from Furitek, including the gears. The thing comes ready to run. There's nothing to do. Just put in the 4 batteries into the transmitter, and you're good to go. So I already had prepared the car, and just fire it up now. When you start it first, you have to bind it, but this is no problem. This is very precise. It can really crawl very slow. and it's really quiet. But it also can take up some speed. Just a little size comparison. This is how the car looks from the underside. There are metal suspension arms, metal universals, even the steering linkages are made out of metal. Quite a good quality. And the plates here at the side of the body are made of thin metal too. It might look not so nice that you see the battery and the receiver and the ESC and everything, or here the cable, but function before design. Now let's have a short look on the Furitek app. You can download it for iOS or Android. After the installing, the car and the transmitter has to be turned on. Then there's a button you have to press, and the Wi-Fi module finds your car. I had done already some settings, but now let's look at the buttons. Here is a button for the car where you find the device. Here you have some settings, which you can adjust a little bit. This here is the main menu. There are 4 points: the telemetry, the running, the throttle, and the throttle curve. Here on telemetry, you find the rounds per minute, which the motor does, and the throttle input you gave on the transmitter. You also find the voltage of your battery and the temperature of your motor. And here we have the throttle curve. The menu point running explains itself. You can set some things like the brake, how far your throttle should go in forward and reverse, or the cutoff points for your batteries, and so on and so on. The next thing is throttle. There are some settings too, but it's crucial to set the neutral point at zero. Therefore, just use the calip button. It gives you some questions and you have to answer them with OK and do the same thing which are said to you on your transmitter. The last point in the menu is the throttle curve. This is the one I like the most. For normal, it was a linear line, and I changed it to an exponential curve. This gives you a lot of more control about your car, and you also can see it when you go just into the telemetry menu. For my car, the reverse curve is the same as the forward curve, just only mirrored. Therefore, I have to press the button down there at the right side. The adjustment of the throttle curve is quite easy. Just click on one point on the curve, and then put it the way you want it. So for now the car is set and I'm happy to go with it. So let's go on telemetry and let's see how it reacts when the car is running. So let's have a short test on the ramp of Cauliflower Mountain. Whoops. So quiet and so much control. Can't wait to get this car on the mountain. So as a result, this is a great crawler for me. You get lots of components here, like the brushless motor, the Wi-Fi module, metal linkages. It's easy to adjust over the app. For the look, like it or not, that you see some of the components. But all in all, there is a big cage all around. It looks nice. The price is about 280 to 300 euro, dollars, pound or whatever. If you're interested in the car, you should keep in mind that you have to deal with many and very small screws. And also please keep in mind that this is not an all-day crawler or a Sunday crawler. You have to deal with many small and tiny parts. And also this car needs a lot of maintenance. So let's get to the three cons I found. The first thing is that the tires don't stay on the rims. The bead of the tires is very small and so are the gaps in the rims and they get lost very easy. You can glue on the tires, but this is a very challenging task. You have to work very precise and very fast. So I leave it here and better put on the tires as they come off. The second thing is you have to check all the screws before and after you are driving. This is special for the wheel nuts. These are little hex screws without anything that keeps them in place. There is no rubber seal in, but as an advantage you can use a Tamiya wrench. And this is the smallest hex you have and it will fit on the wheels. And the third thing, and this is the worst, are the drive shafts. They look nice, they are made out of metal, but see the silver tubes? There is a thread at this side and at this side. As I got the package, I shook it just for a test and hear rattling sound inside. And the thing was, one of these tubes get lost. And as soon as it gets lost, the two parts of the drive shaft here and there aren't connected anymore. There is a little pin inside, which is around 0.5 millimeters by 3 millimeters, and luckily I found it. But the reconnection of the drive shafts took me around half an hour. Then I drove for 5 minutes and both shafts got lost. And another hour has gone. So my solution for this thing is, I hope you can follow, I screwed it together, then open up this tube a little bit, around 1 or 2 millimeters. Then I took a toothpick and my Tamiya threadlock gel, which is a very great stuff, and I didn't put it on the thread. I just put it in between here and then screw it on again, so the tube is kind of glued to this part of the drive shaft. I don't do any of the gel here to get another gluing point, because here the drive shafts have to work and move a little bit inside and outside. But for now, the tubes didn't move. And I think they will stay in place. And this is the main and the worst con I have about the car. But all in all, I'm happy now. As another solution, you can order new drive shafts, which are a complete other type, on Orlandoo's homepage. but I have no experience with it, so I leave it away, and I want to drive with the car yet and not in 3 or 4 weeks. But maybe I like these little ones, and there's something more content coming up this channel. But besides the three cons, I'm really flashed of this awesome little crawler. So this is everything of my presentation of this car. If you've got some questions, the comment section is yours. And as always, please like, share and subscribe. This really helped me out. See you soon on RC Birds.